Hey guys, this is Crazy Dave for you with another Diablo 3 Witch Doctor guide for patch 2.1. This time I want to show you how to build and gear up your fresh level 70 Witch Doctor. You don't need legendaries for this, but legendaries helps. Yeah. But that you already should know. So my gear is purely only rare crafted guide and gear and found gear. Oh, there's a socket missing. Let me check this. Blam. Okay, well, we are now on 165,000 DPS and not yet 4 million toughness and 22k healing. Our helmet is still missing, so we get a helmet now. I don't want to craft one because the first thing you should gamble for at Kardala is Mask of Jerem for our build. It's a pet build, so Mask of Jerem is the thing you really want for your build. For this build. Okay, you should got some more blood shards from your way to 70. I already gambled a ton, so I only got 38 left. Let's try this. Maybe we are lucky.
That costs too much.
We are not lucky. Okay. What we got here? Basically, on your helmet, you want high int, vitality, crit chance, and a socket. So here we got high int, high vitality, and life percentage. Okay, the only thing with socket is this. Here we got vitality and life percentage. Okay. Int and life percentage. And a socket? Okay, maybe. Maybe we can try this one out. I thought I don't get enough crafting materials so that I can re-roll this. But this should fit for the beginning. So we put an amethyst in this. Because we want just more life. 500k should be enough for the beginning. We are still on normal mode, so now I want to show you the build, what skills I'm using. For the gear, it's pretty easy. So I already said for the helmet, high int, high vitality. We don't get the high vitality, but we got life percentage, and usually you want crit. You wanna get to a 50% crit chance. We are now at 12%. We had a way to go for this. So the 50% crit chance is because your pets only benefit from a crit chance at 50% and less. Not above this. Above this, your pet doesn't benefit anymore. So you want exactly 50%, and the rest you want other stats like intelligence, which brings you damage and survivability through the auras. What you get through the intelligence. Oh, sorry for my English. It's Okay. Where we were. Okay, so on a helmet, high int, vitality, crit chance, and a socket. On your shoulders, you want high int, high vitality, armor, and life percentage. We here get int, vitality, no armor, but we got area damage and life per second. It's okay for the start. Okay, then for your chest, you want high int, high vitality, 3 tokens, and life percentage or armor. We got int, vitality, armor, and our three sockets, so it's fine. Okay, next thing, the gloves. For the gloves, you want damage only stats. The gloves only gives you damage. You don't want any defense stats on that. So you roll for high int, attack speed, crit chance, crit damage, maybe average damage for the lack of attack speed. But usually you only want damage stats. These gloves are crap. You get only defense stats on this. Okay, the reduced resource cost, but no, you don't want it. So I don't have enough crafting materials, so I have to live with that. But I think we should find better one. So for the belt, you want high int, vitality, armor, and life percentage. Instead of life percentage, you can also get resistance to all elements. You should basically balance your defense stats, which means a balance between armor and all rest. You should always check your gear. How much armor did I have? How much all rest did I have? And then you can decide which you want more. Okay, for the braces. The braces also for damage. You want physical damage on this. High int, vitality, and crit chance. We got all of this here, and it's fine. And I think we also got, yeah, we got the highest roll on physical damage, the highest roll on crit chance. That's really good braces. Okay, then the pants. On your pants, you want int, vitality, armor, and two sockets. We only got one socket, okay, it's unlucky, but we're working on that. It's just our start gear. I put this together in 30 minutes. I just crafted it and checked the vendors and this act, so it should be fine. Okay, what's next? The boots. The boots, you want high vitality, movement speed, maybe auras. There's the point. If you got enough paragon levels to get to your 25% movement speed with paragon levels, then do that. Then you don't need to roll movement speed on your boots. So these boots are really not perfect. We got firebats damage, what we don't use. We don't use firebats. And so, as I said, I just 30 minutes crafting and checking vendors for this. Okay, the rings are for damage. You want on your rings high int, attack speed, crit chance, crit damage, maybe average damage for the attack speed. It's the same like the gloves. On the other ring, you want it too. So, on the amulet, you want physical damage, int, crit chance, and crit damage. Physical damage is because you get much physical skills. So your zombie dogs do physical damage, your fetishes do physical damage, so you want that up, trust me. So your weapon, basically you want just a high damage weapon with a socket. I got a not so high damage weapon, but I got a socket, and so I can put up my damage with emerald in it, because critical high critical hit damage is just awesome to push your damage. For the offhand, you want high average damage, high int, vitality, crit chance, maybe percentage of a specific skill like Plague of Toads or Gigantum or Zombie Dogs, if you use Zombie Dogs. But basically, you want clear stats like int, vitality, crit chance. Okay, that's for the gear. First, what you should roll at Cardalas is, as I said, a helmet for Mask of Jerem. Because it gives you increased pet damage and can roll up to 100%, which is pretty awesome for your build. Okay, after that you can try to get some good rings from Kadala, or maybe Tusker and Tio. Tusker and Tio are legendary gloves which gives you your pets attack speed, which is for pet build really awesome. You know that. But be warned, you can spend thousands and thousands of blood shards at Kadala's to get Tusker and Tio. That's why I doesn't have Tusker and Tio. I also don't got the Mask of G-Ram because I spent thousands and thousands of blood shards at Kadala. Okay. That should be enough for your gear. What you should get is Suni set and a Ring of Royal Grandeur. Because you'd only want 5-piece Sunis, but you want the 6-piece set bonus. Okay, then let's check out our build, our skill build. We got a Plague of Toads with Rain of Toads. This thing just let you decide... What the hell? Let you decide where your toads go. You need this because of our main damage sword, our fetishes, which we got from our passive fetish psychophans. We got a 10% chance on hit to summon a dagger wielding fetish. Yeah, okay, that means we have to hit enemies a lot, and there is Plague of Toads really 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 good. Okay, the second skill what to use is Piranhas with the Piranado rune. This is just a 16 second cooldown skill you can use on large groups. You get this, and this sucks the enemies in, so you have your enemies concentrated at one spot and even hit more enemies with your Plague of Toads. So okay, the next thing, Spirit Walk Healing Journey, should be self-explanatory, because it's a oh shit button. You came out of everything, of every situation, and heal yourself for 14% of your maximum health, which is really, really good. Okay, the next thing, Voodoo Dance, Big Bad Slam Dance. The Big Bad Voodoo just gives you a damage buff, for 30%. 30% damage buff, this is just amazing. I mean, your fetishes benefit from it, your zombie dogs, and your Gargantum. Okay, and there we are on the next skill, it's Gargantum. Gargantum with the rune Wrathful Protector. Every 15 seconds, every 60 seconds, oh man, every 60 seconds you can summon this, and for 15 seconds he just shreds your enemies away with his 575% weapon damage attacks. Yeah, you see an elite pack or the champion or whatever, put this on and the champion pack is gone. So then we got our zombie dogs with the leeching beasts rune. These are good. We're playing hardcore, so we need a much toughness and much healing to survive this, because we won't die. With the Leeching Beast rune, you get 4 zombie dogs, which do 30% of your weapon damage. It's physical, it's not that great, but they also heal you for 100% of your life on hit with every attack. Every. Yes? So you basically can't die with this. If you get enough life per hit, you get enough healing. With 4 zombie dogs hitting all the time, and you hitting also, and always got, you get 5 times your life on hit with this. It's just amazing. Okay, passive skills, Fetish Psychophans, as I mentioned before, our main damage source, because they guys, these guys just rock. Pierce of Wail, increased damage by 20%, always good, but your mana costs are increased by 30%. Mana costs? Which mana costs? Really? You get this, don't cost mana, this, don't cost this, this, this. Oh, this costs mana, 250, eh? Whatever! Really, you get just one skill and this has a 16 seconds cooldown, so you don't care about the 30% more mana what you have to pay for this. Then Spirit Whistle, you need this in hardcore. I mean, every 90 seconds you have a second life, so just take this. Midnight Feast, you get one more zombie dog. That's why you have four zombie dogs and not only three. And the damage of your zombie dogs and Gargantum is increased by 50%. 50%! There's... Your zombie dogs and your Gargantum just shred through your enemies. And you stand there and wait. Okay. So this is basically our skill build. You can try Mass Confusion for the zombie dogs, but I prefer them, the zombie dogs, more. And now, now just farming, because with this you can't go Torment 1. Yeah, I want to show you a farm spot now, where I farmed the first 1 to 2 hours and got me straight to Torment 1. It's just fine. Maybe some of you know this spot. It's Act 3. You go to Corv area. You got a high density of mobs here, a high density of champion packs, elite packs, a good chance to spawn a goblin, which can lead you to the vault, where you get awesome loot, and sometimes you got also a bounty in here. You got cursed chests, which are pretty easy because they just spawn a champion pack and then you're fine. And you basically only need 3 to 4 minutes to get through this. 3 to 4 minutes with much gold, few enemies, and oh man, the Spoon of the Horde game is pretty good, by the way. You get so much gold. No gold problems forever, trust me. So you go through here, shred all the things back, loot all the stuff. Oh, what we got here, baby. And the damage upgrade. Maybe we can roll for the life period, maybe we can roll a socket in it. And we got much more damage. So you just go through here, kill all this stuff, loot the items, got crafting material from the items which you don't need. You pop this, this is see, okay, it's normal, but our gear is not even decent, it's just crap. We got crap gear and we threat do this on level 70 on normal. You see, it's just 3 to 4 minutes. Go through it, got champion packs, maybe a goblin, sometimes curse chest, which gives you also enough loot to gear up for Torment. As I said, I done this about 2 hours and was ready for Torment 1. So I am returning to town. This is a really good farm spot for first hours to get your stuff. Okay, I also posted this guide on my Tumblr blog. I will link it to the description. Maybe you want to read it and understand it better, because my spoken English isn't this pretty. Okay, if you liked it, thumb up. If you don't like it, leave a comment. What can I do better? Yeah, and I'm always like it if you subscribe my channel. Okay, see you next time. Bye.